See if we can land the booster separately. Of course, we will get the second stage off and going with the NASA Escapade satellites on board on their way to Mars.
Trajectory continues to look good, seeing good data quality coming down from the vehicle. Body rate response
phenomenal. Great to hear that good data quality.
All seven engines continue
looking
to look
nominal.
Good.
Next up, Miko, which is main engine cutoff. The cheers are real. You can hear them all the way in here.
And we have Miko.
And we have Miko.
And we have good stage set.
We have good stage separation.
And we have ignition on stage two. Both engine parameters look good.
Ignition. Oh, you see the two rockets?
Body rate stamping out nicely. Both BPU engines look good at the high thrust set point. Body rate responses look good. 3 minutes, 43 seconds into flight.
Look at that view.
We have good indication of payload fairing jettison. Both BE3U engines
great.
Continue to look good. Fairing body rate response
jettison.
Phenomenal. Seeing good data coming down from both stages.
Great data. We're 4 minutes into NG2.
And you saw the spectacular view
look
from
good.
Down
body rate
from our GS2.
Responses continue to look good. This is a 9.5 minute burn for GS2. 4 minutes, 25 seconds into flight.
All right, at 9 minutes is when we're expecting the first stage to touch down on Jacqueline.
Approximately 2 minutes remaining in the GS1 coast.
Thank you again, everybody, for joining us for NG2. So far, a nominal mission.
GS2 is now 320 kilometers downrange, traveling at 2.8 kilometers per second. Trajectory continues to look good on both stages.
Clean separation, clean fairing
jettison. Right down the middle of the range track. Engine operating parameters on GS2 look good.
Sounds like our GS2 is having a beautiful ride. The NASA Escapade satellites are exposed to space right now. And we've got GS1 coming down for landing at T plus 9 minutes.
One minute remaining in the GS1 coast. Continue to see good data coming down from both GS1 and GS2. Body rates on both stages look good. BE-3U engines look good.
Everything looking good, looking nominal.
Seeing good TVC
and
MR control.
This moment
on
coming
GS2.
Up is an important one.
Trajectory
it
continues
is. We're
to
going
look good.
To. We're going to relight the BE-4 engines for the reentry
Body
burn.
Body rates nulling out on GS1. The exo turn is complete.
There you go. It's about 300,000 feet, less than 100 kilometers up there, coming in for a landing on the Jacqueline, 375 miles offshore, waiting for the first time to land Blue Origin's New Glenn booster on the Jacqueline.
Continue to see body rates on GS1.
That looks great. We have our booster reentry burn. All three engines.
No matter what happens next, we have had a good day. This is further than we made it on NG1.
That's right.
See indication of engine ignition on GS1. Continue to see good data from GS1.
About a minute and a half.
Engine parameters look good.
Is when we would see.
Confirm engine cutoff.
Never tell me the odds. Return to Earth.
You see it in kind of that horizontal position. We've got the strakes on the base of the booster, which give it lift. So we can basically fly this booster. Of course, we're using the forward fins as well, plus some of our reaction control system. As well as the gimbaling on the BE-4 engines to turn the rocket accordingly. On here, it starts to tilt down.
GS1 now halfway in its flame burn. GS1 systems, GS2 systems continue to look good. GS2 throttle down complete. Responses look good. Eight minutes, 20 seconds from the flight. Landing burn ignition, and we have landing burn ignition. See three good engines.
We've got our booster landing burn.
Engine control looks good.
Of course, those clouds are there.
8 minutes, 43 seconds. Flight deployed. Now down
a great shot
burn.
From our booster.
Standing by for touch. Touchdown. as well, just continuing to expand burn.
Oh,